Hello and welcome back to PA Academy. So this is the continuation to the example we are looking at under division of polynomial, and this is example 3. So if you mix the example 2 or the previous parts of this video, kindly check the description, you'll find a link there. So in this example 3, we are looking at divide and obtain the quotient and remainder when x raised to power 3, that's x cubed minus 1, is divided by x minus 1. So let's draw the long division sign. So here we are going to be having the x minus 1 on this side and then x cubed minus 1. So let's start the division. So we are going to be starting with x raised to power 3 divided by x. So x raised to power 3 divided by x will give us x squared. So the x squared we use it to multiply what we have, this polynomial here. So x squared multiplied by x, we are going to be having x cubed. X squared multiplied by minus 1, we are going to be having minus x squared. So let's subtract. So by the time we subtract x cubed minus x cubed to cancel out, that will give us 0. So now we are left with, so let's start with this one with the highest degree, minus minus x squared. So that will give us plus x squared. We are going to write it as x squared. So then the constant, minus 1 minus, there is no term here, so it will still be minus 1. We'll bring that back to minus 1. So this is what we are left with. Now, we can still divide this x squared. We can still divide you can see have x squared divided by x. So x squared divided by x will give us x. So x squared divided by x will give us x. So that will be plus x. Now we'll use this x to multiply the polynomial we are having here. So x multiplied by x, that will give us x squared. Then x multiplied by minus 1, that will give us minus x. So by the time we subtract this, this will cancel because x squared minus x squared, that's 0. So we'll be left with, so let's be the x come first. So minus, minus x, that will give us plus x. If you can write it as ordinary x. So what we have left is minus 1. Minus 1 minus, there's no constant here. So the minus 1 will come back, be left with minus 1. So with this now, x divided by x, we can still divide it. So we can still divide this x by this x. That will give us 1. So that will be a plus 1. The plus 1, we write it as we add it to the quotient. So the plus 1, if you use it to multiply this polynomial. So 1 multiplied by x, that will give us x. 1 multiplied by minus 1, give us minus 1. Okay. So by the time we subtract this, x minus x is 0. Minus 1 minus minus 1 is also a 0. So our remainder is 0. So now with this example, we've looked at, our quotient, which is q of x, is equals to x squared plus x plus 1. You know, I have explained it before in the previous part that this is our quotient. While our remainder, which is r of x, is equals to what is 0. You can see our remainder is 0. So this is example 3. So now let's look at example 4. Okay, for example 4, we are having divide and obtain the quotient and remainder when x raised to power 4 minus 1 is divided by x squared plus 1. So let's do this. So let's bring out the long division sign again. So what you are going to be having here, divided by, so what is dividing is that's x squared plus 1, and then this x raised to power 4 minus 1. So we are, don't forget, is this x squared, the first term here is what you are going to be using, or the one with the highest degree rather, let's say the one with the highest degree that we are going to be using to divide whatever is inside this space. So now x raised to power 4 divided by x squared. So it's just same, that's x raised to power 4 over x squared. That's same to that as having x raised to power 4 minus 2, which is x raised to power 2. So x raised to power 4 divided by x squared will give us x raised to power 2. So the x raised to power 2 is used to multiply what we have here. So x raised to power 2 multiplied by x raised to power 2, that will give us x raised to power 4. X raised to power 2 multiplied by 1, that will give us plus x squared. So now let's subtract. So this will cancel this because it will give us 0. Now we'll be left with minus plus x squared. So that will give us minus x squared. Then this minus 1, there's no constant, so that would be minus 1 will come back, that would be minus 1. So now, x squared, minus x squared divided by x squared, that will give us minus 1. So let's write it there, minus 1, add it to the quotient. Now, minus 1 multiplied by x squared, that will give us minus x squared. Minus 1 multiplied by plus 1, that will give us minus 1. So now let's subtract this, minus x squared minus x squared. I've explained something like that, minus, let me write it out, x squared minus x squared. So that would be minus x squared plus x squared. You can see that will give us 0. So if this is confusing, you can write it out like this so that you have a clearer understanding. So same will apply. By the time you do this, you are going to be having 0. So with this example now, our quotient, which is q of x, is equals to x squared minus 1, while our remainder r of x is equals to 0. So you can see this is a very simple example, and with this now you know that out division of polynomial is not something very difficult. So you are going to be looking at one more example under division of polynomial. Okay, welcome back to example 5. This is example 5. So you say that divide and obtain the quotient and remainder when 6x raised to the power 4 plus 7x cubed plus 12x squared plus 10x plus 1 is divided by 2x squared plus x plus 4. This is also a very simple one. Don't look at it, that is very long. So now let's draw the table. So what we'll be having here is 6x raised to the power 4 plus 7x cubed plus 12x squared plus 10x plus 1. So this is a long one. So divided by 2x squared plus x plus 4. So now to do this too, so we are going to start with this first term on both sides. So 6x squared divided by 2x squared, that will give us 3x squared. So like I said earlier, you can always write it out so that you can be sure of your division. 6x raised to the power 4 divided by 2x raised to the power 2. Now this 2 can divide the 6, will give us 3. So this x squared, by the time you bring this x squared up, we'll be having it to minus 2. So we'll be left with 3x squared. So that is the 3x squared. Now this 3x squared, let's use to multiply what we have here. So 3x squared multiplied by 2x squared, that will be 6x raised to the power 4. Now, then 3x squared multiplied by x, that will be plus 3x cubed. Now 3x squared multiplied by 4, that will be plus 12x squared. So now let's subtract. So 6x squared minus 6x squared can cancel out because that will give us 0. 7x, this is 6x raised to the power 4 minus 6x raised to the power 4, that will give us 0. Now 7x cubed minus plus 3x cubed, that will give us 4x cubed, plus 4x cubed, there's no need to write the plus here. Then we're having 12x squared minus plus 12x squared. So that will give us a 0. This can cancel out to give us a 0. So now let's bring back this. Then we'll be having plus 10x plus 1. You know, there's nothing here that we are subtracting this from. 10x minus, there's nothing left, so we can just bring it down straight away. We can just assume to that that we have plus 0x and then plus 0. So it won't make any difference to this. But let's still rub it off. So now we are here. Now 4x cubed divided by 2x squared, that will give us plus 2x plus 2x. Yeah. So now let's use this plus 2x to multiply the polynomial we have on this side. So 2x squared multiplied by, 2x multiplied by 2x squared, that will give us 4x cubed. 2x squared multiplied by x, by this x, that will give us plus 2x squared. 2x multiplied by 4, that will give us plus 8x. So let's subtract again. So this will cancel this because it's 0. Now 10, so let's start with the highest power of x. So minus minus 2x squared, that will give us minus 2x squared. So then we are having 10x plus 10x minus plus 8x, that will give us plus 2x. It's just like saying 10x, same thing as saying 10x minus 8x, that will give us plus 2x. Then 1 minus, that's 0, there's nothing here, so we can bring the 1 plus 1. So let's continue. Now we have minus 2x squared. We can still divide this by 2x squared. So by the time we divide minus 2x squared divided by 2x squared, we are going to be left with minus 1. With minus 1. So now let's use minus 1 to multiply the polynomial we have here. So minus 1 multiplied by 2x squared, that will give us minus 2x squared. Minus 1 multiplied by x, that will give us minus x. Minus 1 multiplied by 4, that will give us minus 4. So now let's subtract. So let me just use this, write it here because of space. Let's continue on with this box. So by the time we subtract this, it will cancel out. Then 2x minus minus x, so that will give us 3x. Then 1 minus minus 4, this is plus 1 minus. Okay, I didn't put the minus for this one. Okay, this minus is for this. So we are still corrected anyway. So 1 plus 1 minus minus 4, that will give us plus 5. Plus 5. So with this now 3x squared, you can see that the degree of the x here is less than the degree of x that we have here. So that is, we can stop here. With that now, this is now our remainder. So this is our remainder. So if you want to write out the quotient and the remainder. So our quotient, which is q of x, so our q of x is this that we have at the top, which is 3x squared plus 2x minus 1. While our remainder, r of x, this is it here, 3x plus 5. So that is it for example 5. But before I go, I want to just add this to it. Now, if you are dealing with division of polynomial, now, if we should multiply our quotient, that is q of x multiplied by what we are using to divide it, which is, let's call it the divisor. So that is, let's call it d of x. Then plus r of x, which is the remainder, it should give us the polynomial. It should give us this value. So that means if we multiply this, so if this is our d of x, if we multiply this, use this and multiply it with the quotient, add it to the remainder, you will get this. Okay, let me rub it off so that I can write it more neat and clear. So using this example to explain, what I mean is that if you pick the quotient, now that is 3x squared plus 2x minus 1. If you multiply it by this that we use to divide this main polynomial, multiply by 2x squared plus x plus 4, then plus the remainder, 3x plus 5. Now, by the time you simplify this or you solve this, you are still going to get, it's going to give you this 6x raised to power 4 plus 7x cubed plus 12x squared plus 10x plus 1. You are still going to get this. So I just said I should add this so that you can to let you know. So with that, we've come to the end of division of polynomial. So in the next part of this video, which is the part 6, part 7 or so. But anyway, the next part, we are going to be looking at the factor and remainder theorem. So that's going to be the last part under polynomial. Make sure you don't miss it. So if you find this video helpful, kindly click on the subscribe button to subscribe to this channel. And if you like this video, please click on the like button to show that yes, you truly like this video. And I'll see you all in the next part of this video. So bye for now.